Matthew 26, 71 through 75. Later, out by the gate, another servant girl noticed him and said to those standing around, "This man was with Jesus of Nazareth." Again, Peter denied it, this time with an oath. "I don't even know the man," he said. A little later, some of the bystanders came over to Peter and said, "You must be one of them. We can tell by your Galilean accent." Now, Galilean accent, like, that would be like, you know, if somebody from Alabama came on up here to Nebraska, and they're like, "Hey, y'all," like, you would notice. Like, you'd be like, "Oh, you're not from around here, are you?" You know, that's Peter. There's a bunch of Galileans. They're all hanging out with Jesus. And so Peter swore, "A curse on me if I'm lying. I don't know the man." I know, that's bad. That's terrible. Anybody from Alabama, I've just offended you. I'm sorry, all right? "I don't know the man." And immediately the rooster crowed. Suddenly, Jesus' words flashed through Peter's mind. "Before the rooster crows, you will deny three times that you even know me." And he went away weeping bitterly. In another one of the gospel accounts, in this courtyard area, it's described as, there's big windows on all these buildings, and you could actually see, Peter could see Jesus through one of the windows. And when the rooster crowed, Jesus looked out directly at him, and they met eyes. And Peter knew he had failed. He knew he had fallen short of the promise and commitment he had made. And he ran away weeping. I don't know about you, but I've had those moments. I've had those moments where I feel like, man, I've fallen short of the life Jesus has called me to. I made this promise. I made this commitment. And I haven't lived it out the way I thought I would. And I've fallen. Working in student ministry for all these years, I've seen this week after week. I've seen so many students throughout the years give their lives to Jesus in the waters of baptism. And in that moment, they make this commitment to say, "Jesus, you are Lord and Savior of my life. I'm going to live for you until the day I die." And time after time, they fall short and they come back and they are crying and they are broken and they feel guilt and shame for what they've done or how they've been living, how they've fallen short of the commitment they've made. We've all had those moments where we feel like we've fallen short